We are heading out right now, Friday afternoon, just got out of work. Me and Knight are going up, meeting Josh and Dave. And we're bringing Summit with us this time.
There he is. Hope we're doing all right. I'm gonna miss this little one who can't go with us because she's too little right now. But someday soon. And you're too little too, so you're gonna be hanging out with Hazel. And Mommy.
Just gonna jump in the car now, get some gas. I got some lightweight stuff. My pack is still like, I don't know, 60 pounds. I don't know how heavy it is. I just know it's hard to pick up. So I got to hike in 5 miles with it tonight. So we're going to see how that works out. And we're just going to wing it. Let's go. Oh, yeah. I didn't tell you. Oh, I did on a prior video. Marshall Colden. And if we're not beat to death, Cliff and Redfield on Sunday. Colden's beautiful. I want to get to the top of that. It's one of my favorites. So we will see you at the trailhead, Upper Works trailhead, where I'm going to meet up with Josh and Dave.
You ready to go?
Yep.
You ready to go, Summit? Yeah, and that's a yes. I was lying on the grass of Sunday morning of last week, indulging in my self-defeat. My mind was thugged, all laced and bugged, all twisted, wrong and beat. We're here, Upper Works Trailhead.
And right on time, we got Josh. We got Dave Ryan.
You'll see other faces later on.
This is a little cottage where Theodore Roosevelt was staying when he heard McKinley was shot and he was dying and he was going to be president. Right here, and I'm sure this thing tells us all about it. McNaughton Cottage.
There he is, Teddy Roosevelt. I did say Teddy, right? Or I said Theodore, one or the other.
Teddy. Yeah, I know. I didn't know if I said Franklin Roosevelt or something.
Hey, let's start over in case I did.
No, we'll leave it. We got bugs landing all over us. I don't think they're black flies. They look like little house flies. They're not the tiny little
black flies that we usually see. But they're biting. Dave Ryan got bit pretty good. Yeah, it does suck, Dave Ryan, to have to carry. Hold on. I didn't see the bag of the front.
That's my tent.
That's your tent. Your tent's enormous.
This is my tent. I got mattress pads in here.
That's it?
Mostly.
You have the big ones,
I got a few
man.
Other
that,
things
get
in
that,
there.
Get that blow up one.
I didn't, yeah. I
but I'm not one to talk, man.
I'm not one to talk because my bag's pretty heavy.
I brought the foam and the egg crate one. Figured I'd double stack them.
Yeah.
I'm paying for it, not that decision right now.
Yeah, I mean, the foam isn't heavy.
Right. Yeah, this isn't heavy. It's like just annoying.
Looks like the furnace from a building that was there.
Can I do this?
Read the thing, it says it. What are you trying to do?
No hands free.
You won't be able to see, but your hands free.
All right, I'm just going to set
my camera's bouncing over because I got this dog. Who's so excited? These are relentless. They're relentless. And we put a bunch of D on, and they don't care at all. Ashes makes another appearance. All right, so Summit just drank his water. Dave Ryan sweating. We're all sweating. Look at this. Look at this. Can you see any moisture or condensation?
It's like the rainforest out
here. It is hot. But the bugs calm down. The bugs calm down. And I want to knock on wood. If I only could find any.
Alright, so we stopped.
This little bag.
We're still on the hike in. It's like 6 miles in.
And
we're sweating like crazy. It's really humid and warm, and just got some water and some chocolate, pounded like half of a fruit and nut chocolate bar, and some beef jerky, some water, and ready to roll. I get to that tent site, tent up probably about, get there about 10 o'clock. It's like 9:30 right now, you said?
Yeah, 9:20. Got some like camp soap.
Where did you guys put your bear canisters?
What's that?
Did you guys put your bear canisters away yet?
No. So we're here, we're set up. Josh got his tent. We didn't get a lean-to. There's a bunch of lean-tos. We didn't get any of them. The parking lot, as you saw, had a lot of people in it. We're set up over here. Summit just ate.
Summit, don't chew on that. People are sleeping.
Oh, he did great. He did perfect. Perfect hiking dog. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Put it inside that can.
Alright, let's blind ourselves here. Alright, so this is good night. And in the morning we grab Marshall, maybe Colden. What do you think?
I think we should just go with like Marshall and Colden. And then, like, pack up, because they said, well, you guys said, like, that's a whole, like, they're separate.
What do you, I'm not even gonna, don't listen to him.
Cliff and Renfield are, yeah, they are separate.
Hard.
Everything's hard. Say goodnight.
Good night.
And beef. It's my favorite. So good.
That's from an early video.
Wasn't it like one of our first like hiking meals?
Yeah, that's the first time me and you were out in the, you know, camping by ourselves in the middle of this place.
Yeah, was it? It was winter. Was it? No.
No, not winter.
It's Cascade and Corvette.
Probably fall. Not Cascade and Corvette. We did Chase.
Oh yeah.
I think it was tabletop and fall.
Yeah.
Check out that Tabletop and Phelps video if you want to see some chili mac and beef.
Well, we camped right by this lean-to. The guys that, we got a pack in there still. We could have still threw our stuff in there, I think. But we'll figure it out.
What are you doing, bud?
Popping some water. We're gonna need it.
Yeah, we are.
So, kind of a plan change. We're going to do Colden first. Filtering up some water. Going to take, what, 3 or 4 liters each.
All right, Summit successfully made it down the stairs over here at good old Lake Colden. Is this Lake Colden? Or is this Avalanche Lake?
I believe this one's Lake Colden.
And the trap dike. I believe it's right over, yeah, it's right over there.
On the other side.
Yeah, right where the crack is on the very end. And you should be able to see the bridge that goes around the side over down there. the chingari on the side.
Wow.
That's a Sebastian Maniscalco reference in case someone's like, what was that from?
Living the life. Oh, I remember last time I was right here. I had a bald head and I was a bobcat. And I was
enjoying it, man. It's just like today. How you doing, Dave Ryan?
Ready to jump in.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
I wouldn't mind to take a swim, actually. Once we get down and pass us, I'm swimming.
Back.
I'm swimming. I don't care.
Too.
Boxers and going in.
I'm gonna be the first to jump in. I've always tested out the cold by jumping in.
Look at that. That is a pick, man.
So where we were just going down the ladder over there, bridge. And we came over there. Saw me. I'm swimming right here when I'm on the way back. So much stairs.
This is the point of the hike where I say how ambitious we were for calling four peaks. We're almost at the top of Colden. And I'm actually happy it's going to be Summit's first high peak instead of Marshall. Because it's beautiful up there. In Marshall's, no views, and a pain. Someone's doing great. I was flying ahead of everybody else, and now I'm in the back. Whew. Oh, we're doing good. We're doing well. We're doing all right.
Whew. You can't see it on the camera here.
Oh, wow.
But you can see the bridge that we crossed three hours ago, maybe? Where are my fingers pointing here? The one that we came down the ladder with Summit on the cross. He's doing excellent. He's doing great. I mean, these dogs can run 30 miles a day in the desert, so in Africa, so they should be good. It's me we gotta worry about. I feel good though. But yeah, Colden today, Marshall in the morning. That's what it's gonna be. Josh was like, oh, we're gonna grab all four. That's just too ambitious, man. These, you can get four high peaks, but you gotta do like great range. You can't be doing separate mountains that far apart. You got up there, good boy, stay. All right, let me get back out here. See you at the top. Yes, yeah, hold my hand. Why don't you walk right in front of me, right across.
Really?
Yep. Gotta drop down, okay? Make sure you don't slip. I'm gonna hold your hands, you just scoot down there. You got it? Like on me, you got it when you're both your hands.
Yeah.
Skirt down there and like Colden down there. Pretty sure that's Marshall way out there.
Yeah, we're not heading that today.
Well, let me see, we came through here. I think it is. Okay, I lost audio here on this one. Unfortunately, so I guess I'll just kind of ad lib or fill in here. This is the area where it was the hardest to get Summit up. That ladder is about 20 feet straight up, and he's not getting up there. So I had to come down here, this ledge here, and Knight was down there with him because Josh and Dave went ahead. So Knight had Summit jumped about 6 feet, and Knight had to push him up, and I yanked on his leash. But he got up, so all's well. Summit is enjoying the view. He's looking around like, what? What? Dave and Josh are probably on the summit. They left us, how long ago? An hour ago, probably?
Way more than that.
Yeah. We weren't going slow. We found Dave Ryan and Josh. The float lands. Now they look float from here.
Hey, there's the bridge we went across.
Yeah, that's the bridge.
Remember a lot of old Iroquois and Algonquin
made it to his first high peak summit, and it happens to be Mount Colden, one of the most beautiful ones with great views. And congrats Summit on that first summit. And I also want to give a little shout out to Latia. She's in my son's grade, said she's a fan of the channel, and thanks for, she came up to us and told us that. Very nice, glad you enjoy it. And you gotta get up here if this is something you might enjoy. All right, so we'll see ya. I'm not gonna pull this camera. I'm not even sure if you're getting the audio with the wind up here. Oh, damn, I'm trying to get away from this wind. There's definitely some drop-offs where I wish I recorded Summit scrambling up them. It was pretty impressive. Two of them I had to grab a hold of his collar, and not his collar, his leash, and pull, which I didn't really want to do, but it's the only way he's getting up, and it's wrapped around his body, so it's not like his neck was getting pulled. Alright, so we'll see you back down. We're going swimming in Lake Colden. I'm telling you that right now.
I just took a spill. Down those. Up further. It hurt. Real bad.
I wonder if you can see this. All bruised and cut. I'm not bleeding too bad.
I didn't hit my head on the ground. That's a positive. Oh, then Knight decided to bend his pole in half.
No.
Knight, you couldn't. Pull, it was stuck. You didn't have to pull. You don't pull it sideways. You pull it straight out.
Well, I had both of my.
That's what happened. Right before I fell down the mountain.
Yeah, I fell, and this was still on the ground, and it pulled it and bent it.
Yeah, Colden. Oh man, that just is on fire. I think I'm still in good spirits.
Yeah, that room.
It freaking burns. It feels like someone's holding a lighter to my shin. Look at the bruise and just rip. I'm surprised it didn't rip the skin right off. I guess I'm lucky. That hurt. I didn't smack my head on the rocks. Thankful for that.
Yeah.
I can still walk. I pulled my other leg. Pulled way out over here. I did like a split. And it hurts. It hurts real bad when I stand up. I really hope I can do Marshall tomorrow with this. But we're going to find out. I need to get two, at least get two. The caretaker's probably over there like, what is this guy doing?
It's not the first time.
No.
We all smell.
Yeah, well, you're gonna still smell it. I'm gonna be just fine and dandy.
It's too nice.
Feels good.
Is there alligators in this?
There might be, actually.
Maybe some.
What? Don't say anything.
I know.
Whoa. Oh, shoot.
Yeah.
Ow.
Whoa. Dead.
You can pull it the other. Ah. 1, 2, 3. Oh, it feels good, though.
Yeah.
You gotta basically army crawl out, Knight.
That's what I did.
Just army crawl.
That's what I did.
It's like you're just on like.
You gotta spread your weight out.
It's like Toys R Us.
It smells horrible.
It's like Toys R Us, not Toys R Us. Chuck E. Cheese. Instead of balls in the pit, it's just a bunch of sticks.
Mud and sticks. Yeah, the sticks hurt.
Like right.
So, did you get some of the dirt off you too?
I think so.
If anything, I'm getting more dirt.
Yeah, I know.
That's a.
It's just good to get the sweat off.
Sweat off at least. I'm gonna get wet. That's probably the smarter way.
Whoo!
This wasn't
sweet. No, this isn't like your regular beach. There's literally blow down. This stuff is all that you feel underwater.
It
was a million sticks.
It did it.
Worth it? I think it was. I feel definitely cool. I feel refreshed. Water filter number 2. almost back to our lean-to. I kind of wish I swam in this. It's much clearer. Put on some triple antibiotic ointment on my scrape after going in that Lake Colden. This looks a little cleaner. I may just come in here. I'm not too far from the lean-to. Summit is passed out. You can see him in between the trees there. Passed out. Gotta get some food in here too. All in a day's work. All in a day's work. I gotta wash this. I wash this pup off in the water.
Oh, you'll see it. It'll happen like in the next couple days.
Just because you're not getting clean.
Yeah. What the heck is going on over here? What are you doing, man?
I can't get this turn.
So we're still here. Taking a break. Taking a break at the dam. At the dam. My head doesn't work anymore. I want to go in there and rinse off again. It's definitely so so clear and clean looking compared to that Colden. Ugh, that's pretty bad. I gotta get this pup in there and look at the mud on this guy. After I already cleaned him. All right, let me go do that now. I know you're so sleepy, this guy. He was all just laying down sleeping. All right, so it's dinner time. Summit's passed. No, you're good, buddy. I'm sorry. Lay down.
Yeah.
It's up to lean, too. What happened is that we got the guys still here. They were supposed to leave, but two of them went the wrong way. So the ranger told the other guy to stay here that was going to leave. So now we're going to have some company tonight. So hopefully they get back safe. They went the wrong way and they're inexperienced. It's their first day. The guy that went the right way was their friend, and he is a 46er like three times over, do you say?
Yeah.
They made the decision, okay buddy, his bladder broke and he was talking to someone else to get help, and he was giving him a new bladder. I don't know why he couldn't wait for that. It doesn't seem like it was a big deal, but they're like, no, we're gonna go. No, that's good.
Well, we're boiling here.
Well, look at that!
Is your better now?
This is my favorite chicken teriyaki Mountain House. I mean, not the brand Mountain House, it's decent, but chicken teriyaki is my favorite Mountain House meal. And Knights was chili mac and beef he had this morning. And right now he's having some lasagna with meat sauce. Let me lick that dead cat. Make sure you're not getting the furs from my microphone. Alright.
It might have got
lasagna, meat, cheese. It looks pretty good, and it smells pretty darn good. All right, let's get this poured in, man. We gotta get these in here hot.
All right, close.
Get to close. Go for a nice dog. I don't know what you want. It might be a little soupy. No, it's all right. You got sauce and crap. Actually, what does yours need?
One and a half cups.
Yeah, you're good, dude. That's good.
Can I
have
just have
chicken sandwich? Yeah, you can have some, dude.
Paired their menu down from what it used to be.
I've never had lasagna.
I never did either. Let me taste some of yours.
Yeah.
When they first introduced that,
I'll give you a little bit of yours. You can give me a little bit of mine. College.
I went to MVCC for a year.
Well, you gotta do something in the video. It's just a guy getting beat up going up a hill.
Yeah.
They were decent size. Good. Decent size. You got the chicken on there. You got the lettuce, the tomato.
Yep.
He's gonna be good.
12 with
that. Anyways, what's the story we were saying? You know what's funny? The guy went back down and looked for his friends.
Oh, wow.
But,
no, he went to go pump water.
Is that what he said?
Yeah, the ranger's going to get his friends.
All right. He went to go pump water. The ranger's going to get the friends who are heading the wrong way out to the lodge. That's not good. We're on the other side. That's it on there. Man, this is hitting the spot.
Check the teriyaki. After today, who knows? Maybe I'll sneak out your glasses.
Back some coffee. Knight's got some coffee.
After today,
it looks dark in there, but it's not really dark over here.
But sometimes, I think my normal time somewhere between, especially when I'm out in the woods, 6:30.
Nope.
You're probably
taste, buddy.
Oh, it's really hot.
still.
Especially tomorrow.
Yeah. But don't worry about
just
us.
Don't spill it.
I won't sleep here tonight.
Went back to the lean-to and just like hung out there, and I was like, we should probably just stay here because like I don't know where I'm going. So like we waited there for a while, and then we heard some like rustling, and I thought it was a bird because I saw a bird flying. I was like, Joe, do your whistle thing, because he like pulls on his lip and does like a loud ass whistle.
Yeah.
And some lady was like, hello? And we're like, sweet. And we asked them, we're like, all right, we need to get to like, well, we didn't say that. We said, we're trying to get to a suspension bridge and a dam. I'm like, wherever that is. And they're like, oh yeah, we're going that way. They actually gave us a map because I left my GPS and my map here.
Oh, you didn't have your GPS?
No,
I told the ranger you had GPS.
Oh, man.
No. If I did,
the pictures I took,
I would have been here a couple hours ago. But,
is that him, Jonah? Is that a bird?
Oh. No, that wasn't him.
I heard that bird at like 4 in the morning. Here, whatever that is.
Did he give you this stuff?
The ranger did. Oh, I've been with it then.
He gave us like these skills.
No, there's people.
These people across the way here. Their water filter broke.
Oh.
So I pumped them water, and in exchange they gave me food. So
I got food for you.
Very nice.
That goo will hit nice.
Mm. Did you give him a goo?
Someone got a goo.
This is your goo?
No. I don't know where he got it.
Oh, he probably got it from those people. They give him a bunch of stuff.
Yeah,
they gave him like 2 meals.
So you're all together?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we're hiking together, yeah. Come on up.
No, man, go ahead. You got room to sleep down here, too, if you want to.
Yeah, we got a good amount of space.
Summit, what do you think? What do you think? Pretty cool, eh?
You just want to say, like...
You want me to tell the story?
Yeah, if you can.
Okay, so...
Thank you.
This is Lockheed Martin. I work for Lockheed Martin, or I'm retired from Lockheed Martin. But every year, Lockheed Martin has a hike, and they try to get somebody on all 46 peaks of Lockheed rep, and everybody honors of that. So today, we honored Staff Sergeant Frank Kamen, who's the brother of one of my friends. And my friend had a party earlier this summer. I went to the party, and this guy was actually at the party. And I didn't know who he was, and I saw my friend 2 weeks later, and I says, hey, who is that guy at the party that looks just like you? And he says, that's my brother, and he just died on July 4th. Mm. So one thing led to another. I told him about the hike and everything, and from Florida, they texted me up. Florida was where his funeral was. So from Florida, they texted me up these two pictures, and we went and got a banner made.
That's awesome.
And we honored him on... Redfield and Cliff Mountains.
Which are, to me, I already said this earlier in the video, the toughest mountains out here. And this guy's done them all like 3 times. It's crazy.
Allen's the toughest.
Allen's the toughest. It's the longest. I don't think it was, I feel like it wasn't that bad because it was just a lot of long hiking. But
yeah. Allen, you know what the thing about Allen is? It's such a long hike, and if you do it like in the winter, oh, it's just brutal.
Because
you're breaking,
trail.
And it's so brutal. And it's like you go in the winter, you know, it gets light so late, and you start in the dark and you end in the dark.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I only did Whiteface and Esther in the winter, and it was this last winter actually, and I was really surprised. I thought I was going to be so out of shape, there's no way I could do it. I was telling my friend he's probably going to have to take my son up the rest of the way, but when I got there, I felt fine. It feels great. I feel like the snow filled in all the crevices and it made it a lot easier. But
oh, yeah.
Well, thanks for sharing that Staff Sergeant story.
It's very cool.
Yeah, I think it is.
Yeah, so he served in Korea.
Yeah, he took us down the most.
So the guys got back. They're all safe and everything. But they just went back and forth to try to filter some water, and they were unable to get the filter to work. So we gave them my filter. They're down there using it. The other guy was here with the war veteran, Korean War veteran guy. He had to call his wife. So he had my phone, and I guess you can get service, the ranger said, down by the flowed lands, standing by a certain rock or something. Must be something special for emergencies. I don't know what's up with that. But So he's down there. Hopefully he can get a call to his wife and let her know he's safe, and they're not coming home tonight because they're staying right here.
I'm gonna fit in here somewhere.
At least they got back. I got kind of scared from those guys. They were like out there, and it was getting dark.
Sammy, who's your favorite trouble?
That's probably gonna be it for tonight, but we'll see you in the morning. Oh no, we got. I didn't tell him. We're not doing Marshall tomorrow. We're not doing it. I know it sucks because we have to come back, but it doesn't suck because we can't let Josh go on his leg. He had like a stress fracture that was supposed to be healing and almost all the way healed, but now it's swollen all out. Do you want ibuprofen, by the way, Josh?
I'm good, thanks, man.
You sure?
Yeah.
I got acetaminophen, ibuprofen, aspirin.
No, I don't take pills.
All right, he just lets it swell up. And that's... Josh just lets it swell up. And that's news from the lean-to. Back to you, Dave.
Yeah, so I ate Colden for breakfast, lunch, and dinner today.
You must be full.
Hey, Dave.
What?
How many calories and electrolytes did Colden have?
Well, it was full of calories, but whatever electrolytes it provided, you just sweated right out, so.
Not enough.
Not enough. No. It didn't get the job done in that regard.
I mean, you ate it for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, though, so.
Yeah, I needed a Gatorade to back it up.
What'd it taste like?
It was pretty basic. It didn't do a whole lot for me in that regard. It was just checking the boxes.
Good morning,
guys.
Morning. So we're not going to grab Marshall today. Josh has a hairline fracture in his shin that he had before he got here. And he went to the doctor, and they said that it was good, and he was healing, and he'd be all right to come, but yeah, it's all swollen up right now. So there's no way he can do it. And so we're not going to... Can Marshall, so unfortunately, yeah, you already know it from the title of the video, but just got cold and I'm happy to be out here. There's no place else I'd rather be, really. It was painful.
That doesn't look too bad, though.
I just want to get home and take a shower because we all stink. First, we're going to go to the diner, though. I'm not sure which one, but... we gotta hike the 6 miles out of here. 6 miles in took us like 3 hours. It's just so bad, just rocks and wet. It's wet rocks, roots, mud the entire way. I wish I got some of that, but I was so grimy that I didn't even have my camera out. I just had to look down at the ground the entire time. Maybe I'll get some of it on the way out, but yeah, it was bad on the way in, and that was dark and uphill. It beat the crap out of all of us. Downhill should be a lot better on the way out, at least for me.
This is our memorial of this monument erected by filial affection of the memory of our dear father, David Henderson, who accidentally lost his life on this spot 5 to September 1845. I knew it was 1800s. I thought it was 1860. But a guy was out here hunting. He went to go set his gun down next to him. And the butt hit the ground and it shot his head off. And he was sitting on that rock, I guess.
And I've heard two versions of the story. One version is they had a gun here, and he went to pick the gun up, and it went off.
Oh.
And shot him in the head and killed him. The son witnessed it.
Oh, he witnessed
it. And the other is the guide picked the gun up and went to shoot and hit him in the head. I don't know which story is right.
I heard that one too, where he put the butt on the ground. He went to sit down on the rock, and he went like that. With those old guns, he hit the butt on the ground and just blew it down.
But anyways, so he was the one that would actually pay all the people that were working at the mine.
Right.
You know, that was just, so they brought with mules, they brought the workers did, and put that monument up to honor him.
Yeah.
So he was kind of, he was like a good guy. And now that we're talking about all this, so Colden, what climbed Cold Mountain, Colden was another investor in the mine. And the deal with him is... To get him to invest, he was kind of like, I don't know, you got that impurity in there, I don't know if I want to invest in this or not. So they says, if you invest in the mine, we'll name a mountain after you. So that's how Colden got
really?
His name. Yeah. So it's like that's got his name on it, and he didn't do nothing. He that's probably crazy. Never even climbed it.
Right.
Jeez.
You know, I got crazy. To thinking too.
I didn't know that.
We got all this modern technology. We can get water, all this stuff, bring some nice food and stuff. I'm like, some of these people hiked this when it was really primitive.
Yeah, they didn't have electrolytes.
You got most of it started what? They followed either creek beds or the old mining roads.
That's what I'm talking about. This is what we're dealing with all the time. For 3 miles. Wait, 6 miles. 3 hours.
Okay. So they could regulate the water flow. Oh, I got you.
That's up.
I have to go back and look. Does it have on there when those furnaces all closed up? Yeah.
You go down to the pond.
Oh.
Yeah.
And, yeah, no. It's just right. Away. I mean, not too many boulders here, but mud, boulders, and water, roots. Yeah, so that was the memorial that we missed on the way in the dark. This is off to the side there.
We'll see you at the car for real this time. In like 3 hours.
Oh, can I get one of those also, please? Thank you.
Would you get Coke, Dr. Pepper?
If you guys don't have Dr. Pepper, we'll take Coke. So, we both got Coke.
The menu doesn't say it, but he said Dr. Pepper, and she didn't say no right away, so I was like...
They gave Summit a nice bowl of ice water. Which is nice. We're at Walt's Diner in Old Forge. Closing it up. Dave went home because he had to family party. So we're stopping here to eat. I don't know, we're a couple hours, probably two. No, what was this, an hour and a half away from where we were at Trailhead?
Yeah, not bad.
All right, so we're starving. This is going to be delicious. I got to watch them drink their Cokes until they come out with mine. She's got it right there. Summit's getting two Hoffman hot dogs. Two Hoffman hot dogs. It's awesome. This all looks amazing.
Do you guys want extra bites or anything?
I think we're good with this.
Okay, perfect. I'll bring you sodas in a second.
Awesome, thank you. So this is all me and Knights right here. Summit's hot dogs. There's a Reuben. Reuben looks good. Turkey club. Grilled cheese, bacon, and tomato, and some fries. So just dig in. They came with one of these things.
Yeah, they come with a patty melon. I think I was supposed to get fries.
You go to town on that Summit. You go to town. I think I'm gonna end the video here. You don't really care about this part. I like the food parts, but. All right, so we only got. We only got one mountain, but it was a great mountain, and it was a good time. We didn't get hurt too bad, and there's nothing else to it. You saw Colden. Knight got his. What Knight? What is
your peak? Let me see your peak. Let me see your fingers.
We sometimes spend $500.
Oh shoot!
Man, that's
42, 25, 24, over halfway. So you're 46.
Mm-hmm.
Feel good?
Yeah, that's right.
All right, next time we'll try and get more, but you know what? There's no rush.
The mountains aren't going anywhere.
At least I did a mountain, you know? Like, yeah. I'd feel a lot worse if I just went there for no mountain.
Yeah.
At least I got one.
Yeah, for sure. And that happens sometimes, so you get no mountain.
It does.
All right, we'll see you guys on the next trip.
Have you ever